الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، فتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها، ما زاغ عنها إلا هالك، وما استمسك بها إلا مهتد. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد. Before I start, I was just handed a note saying that there are some brothers in the other musalla who are talking and they're loud. Brothers and sisters, the Jum'ah sermon is a serious ibadah. No one should be talking when the khatib goes on the minbar. And I see many times people who are playing with their smartphones. And we know that everyone, alhamdulillah, enjoys the blessings of having a smartphone, but it's not unique to you, it's not limited to you. And many people leave their phones on, they don't put them on silent, especially when we have the third or the second khutbah now, where you start hearing the adhan while the khatib is giving his khutbah. And again, we know you have a smartphone and they have the adhan app. But Jumu'ah is a ibadah. Jumu'ah is a ibadah. When you come here, you leave everything outside. Once you finish, fantashiru. That's when you go into your life and into your basic needs. But when you come here, it's like the salah. Now let me go back to the topic of my khutbah. What is the purpose of our creation? Why were we created? Why did Allah Azza wa Jal create us? Brothers and sisters, this is a central question in our lives. A question, if we provide an answer to, we will give meaning to our journey and to our endeavor in this life. But if we lack an answer to, then we will have a very hard life. We will lack the meaning of our creation and why we're living. And we will be in total loss. Allah Azza wa Jal makes it clear in the Quran that we weren't created in vain. Allah says, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Did you think that we had created you in jest and that you would not be brought back to us for account? So we know that we weren't created in vain and that we were created for a purpose. And for anyone not to know what the purpose is, the purpose of creation, for anyone not to know where he or she fit within the framework of the purpose of creation, this will create a vacuum in their lives. And when a vacuum takes place, a depression will come with it. A sense of irrelevance will take place. A lack of direction in our lives will also take place. Because there is no point of reference. Because you cannot identify what is the reason of your creation. Why are you created? What purpose do you serve? What objective are you required or expected to fulfill? And again, the Quran emphasizes the fact that we were created for a reason by Allah Azza wa Jal saying, أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَن يُتْرَكَ سُدًى. Does man think that he will be left uncontrolled? that he will have no purpose, no objective to fulfill, no mission, no course to take. Well, there is. There is a purpose. And there is a mission. And it is a mighty and a very hard mission. Because Allah Azza wa Jal tells us, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. O man, verily you are ever toiling on towards your Lord, painfully toiling, but shall meet him. So the purpose of this creation is not an easy purpose. It is a very difficult one. Whether we know it or we don't know it. Whether we know where we stand on it or where we stand in vis-a-vis the cause that or the reason why we were created or we don't know, again, that does not mean that the purpose does not exist. But again, lacking the sense, lacking the understanding of the purpose of our creation will create that vacuum in your life. But what is this purpose? What is the reason behind our creation? Why did Allah Azza wa Jal create us? Why, if we don't know this reason or the objective behind our creation, then we have no compass in life? What is it? Well, the Quran again provides us with the answer. Allah Azza wa Jal tells us in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Right? Everyone knows the ayah. I have only created jinns and men that they may worship me. So that is the purpose of life. That is why we were created, to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. But my follow-up question to every one of us. Does really Allah Azza wa Jal need our worship? Does he need our worship? Does he need us? Are we going to provide to Allah? Are we going to make him more mighty than what he is? So, what is it about this worship? Is it coming to the Jumu'ah prayer? Is it praying? Is it fasting? Paying zakah? Giving sadaqah? How do all of that add to the strength of Allah Azza wa Jal? It doesn't, right? You know why? Because the definition of worship is not limited to the literal conception of worship or comprehension of worship. It extends beyond that. It extends to encompass the concept or the notion of imaratul ardh, of inhabiting this land and of building it. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us in the Quran, inna 'aradna al-amanata 'ala as-samawati wal-ardi wal-jibal fa'abayna an yahmilnaha wa ashfaqna minha wa hamalaha al-insan innahu kana zaluman jahula. We did indeed offer the trust to the heavens and the earth and the mountains, but they refused to undertake it, being afraid thereof. But man undertook it, he was indeed unjust and foolish. So, the definition of worship also includes the fact that we inhabit this land and that we have so many sub-objectives, personal objectives, and collective objectives that we serve by our creation. The imara, that means everything that you do in your life, everything when it comes to the personal, to your family, to your community, everything that you do of goodness, that is part of the imara. When you provide to your family, that's part of your imara. When you take care of yourself, that is part of your imara. When you provide to humanity or to your community, that is part of your imara. So this is the trust, this is the amana. that we're all entrusted with as human beings, as mankind. And our prayer here, our limited literal definition of the ibadah becomes part of the imara. What we're doing now is part of the imara. That we're a constructive force in this life. So this is what it really means when Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. So everyone has a role in this life. And for anyone not to understand his or her role, again, we're going back to the notion of depression, of the lack of relevance, the lack of direction. Those who commit suicide, many of them, they cannot figure out the wisdom behind our creation. They cannot figure out the objective that we serve as human beings. They cannot define a role for themselves or identify a role for themselves. That's why many of them commit suicide. But again, the Quran reminds us that while keeping this in mind, that this is the purpose of your creation, also keep in mind that it is a mighty mission. It's not an easy thing to do, because every single human being will go through hardships. Every single human being will face challenges. Every single human being will be faced with obstacles, and every single human being is required to overcome or to try to overcome. We never surrender. We never give up. This is the nature of a human being, that we always try to overcome. إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ كَدْحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ, meaning is that you are in a constant strive to be constructive, to do something good, to continue this long journey and this endeavor until you meet Allah Azza wa Jal. And when we meet Allah Azza wa Jal, then it is the time that we will understand. أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَن يُتْرَكَ سُدًى. Do you think that you were created in vain? Do you think that you were created and you will not be held accountable for your creation and what you have earned and what you have done in this life? So we are in this endeavor. Believers, non-believers alike. All of us are going to be to face hardships, difficulties, and ordeals. All of us are going to be tested. But what distinguishes a believer from others is that we always know that this test or these tests or these hardships that we are going through are for our own good. Not only to purify us, but to also strengthen us. To strengthen us. We all know that while we are overcoming, while we are standing up to these challenges, while we're not withdrawing and laying low, that we are in a constant effort to please Allah Azza wa Jal and to benefit ourselves as well. The Quran tells us, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا وَلَيَعْلَمَنَّ الْكَاذِبِينَ. Do men think that they will be left alone and saying, we believe, and that they will not be tested? We did test those before them, and Allah will certainly know those who are true from those who are false. Everyone is going to be tested, whether we like it or not. We're all going to go through trials and ordeals. And this will reveal the essence of our faith. It will reveal our resilience or the lack of. When you're tested, that's when people know the true you. When you're faced with challenges, that's when I know or you know or we know that whether we can count on one or not, on a person or an individual or not. But it is at the time of ease, it's the easiest thing is to act like you're the previous person. In fact, Al-Mutanabbi, the great Arab poet, when he talked about the coward, when a coward is in a place by himself, it is then when he withdraws his sword and start asking for a fight. Because he knows there is nobody there to put him in his place. But that's a coward. But the real man, which applies to man and woman, is the one who will take on the challenges when they come. And the challenges will define him and will reveal his essence and the essence of his belief. Brothers and sisters, this is not unique to us. This is not limited to us. This is the story and the experience of mankind throughout time and ages. This is the example of all of the prophets, including our beloved prophet, peace and blessings be upon all of them. They all understood that they were created to serve a purpose. They all understood that they were people of mission, that their mission is not an endeavor to secure a self-interest, rather to secure a common greater and a collective interest, a common good for everyone. They understood that they were required to stand for justice and to forbid injustice. They understood that the essence of the divine message, which includes every message sent by Allah Azza wa Jal, which is in essence Islam, the essence of these divine messages is justice. Allah Azza wa Jal tells us in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ. We sent aforetime our messengers with clear signs and sent down with them the book and the balance of right and wrong, that men may stand forth in justice. So that is the essence of our mission. That is the essence of the purpose of our creation, to implement justice. And some might say, how do you reduce the creation and worship in implementing justice? And the answer is very simple. Once you implement justice, you're not going to worship other than the one who's worthy of worship. Once you implement justice, you will not do mischief. Once you implement justice, you will not be a destructive force, rather you will be a constructive force. Once you understand what justice is, you will know what a decent human being is. This is the essence of our religion. And again, Allah Azza wa Jal keeps reminding us in the Quran, when it comes to the purpose of our creation, when it comes to the way we understand and comprehend the purpose of our creation, that it is not enough. When it comes to the issues of justice, when it comes to the way we project ourselves in this life, to hold firm to our belief without following it up with a reflection of this belief. You cannot just say, I believe, without substantiating the belief. And therefore, when you read the criteria of the true embodiment of this sense of mission, this sense of purpose in this life, when you read the criteria, you will find that it emphasizes the work, the actions that will substantiate your claims as much as it emphasizes the claim itself. It is in a very short surah. A surah that every one of us memorizes by heart. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. Everyone knows it, right? Let's listen to the translation, then let's go through the criteria. By the token of time through the ages, verily man is in loss. The general rule that we're all in loss. Except, because if you don't know the reason, the purpose of creation, then we are in loss. Once you have that compass, then you need to know how to use the compass. It's not enough to have a compass in your pocket. Go and navigate or chart a boat in an ocean, open ocean, or go and hike in mountains and you have a compass but you don't know how to use it. What good does it make? You need to know how to use it. You need to have the manual. So Allah tells us what the criteria to the exception not to be in loss. Allah Azza wa Jal says, except such as have faith. Is it enough? Everyone can say, I have faith. In fact, we know many Arab leaders who pretend to be the most religious. They go to Salat al-Fajr and they have the cameras following them. They go pray Jumu'ah and they have the cameras following them. You see them raising their hands and some of them are crying. Well, it is very easy to make the claim. Anyone can make it. But then you have to substantiate. Except such have faith and do righteous deeds. See, you have to do something right. But is it enough? Because once you do the right thing, then you know that you most likely will be tested. Because the general rule is that most men are in loss, so they will not accept that there is someone who is constructive. Because this goes as opposed to their mischief or mischiefs. So you do righteousness, which is a reflection of your faith, but also you remember, you remind one another of the mutual teaching of truth and patience and constancy. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Because people do, even the people of mission, they do get weak. They go through periods of where they feel exposed. They feel scared. They feel threatened. And that's when the true believers, the people of righteous work, need to come together and remind one another of the truth of this great mission. And to remind one another to be patient and not to give up. So brothers and sisters, if we have no sense of purpose, if we don't know why we were created, if we don't understand what is the true definition of worship, if we don't understand what it means to be a constructive force, a man of decency, a man of mission, and the mission is justice, we could be among those who are in total loss. But the exception is what suits us better. The exception is what we want. To be the people of faith, the people of righteous work, and the people who keep reminding one another of the truth and of patience and of steadfastness in our work in this life, because we are going to come to our lives are going to come to an end, and we're going to stand before Allah Azza wa Jal, and we're going to be questioned and asked about what did we do in this life. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. Let me ask you again one more time to please come forward. Here, the brothers in the back, the sisters as well. You will find an empty space in front of you. Just come forward. إذا قيل لكم تفسحوا افسحوا. Okay. I don't memorize the ISO. But when you are asked to make space, make space. Make space. You can do better than this, inshallah. The brothers in the back, I see you. Until we dismantle the wall, I will see everyone, but I see many of you. Come forward, please. Come forward. Okay. Brothers and sisters, so many members of our community feel shaken by the results of the recent elections. And they have every right to feel so. We know that the recent elections were accompanied by poisonous rhetoric against the Muslim community and other minorities, minorities of color, gender. Actually, the women are not a minority. So against women, other minorities of color and faith and ethnicity. And the main focus was the Muslim community. So yes, we have every right to fear, although we hope that things will turn out to be better than what we fear. But you know, brothers and sisters, if you think that this is a reason to be ashamed of your religion now, you're mistaken. If you think that this is a reason for you to shy away from who you are, this is a big mistake. If you think that this is a reason for you to be handicapped by fear, it is a big mistake. If you think that this is a reason for you to give up on your rights, this is a big mistake. This is the time to rise up. This is the time to stand up to injustice. This is the time to project our true faith and our true values. This is the time to show our resilience and our steadfastness. This is the time to say that we are true believers in Allah and that we believe that we are equal in every aspect and that we are, as citizens of this country or who live in this country, enjoy every single right that the majority of people here enjoys. This is the time to say, I'm an American Muslim, I'm a Muslim American. This is the time to say that I will stand for justice. This is the time to reveal our true essence and our true characters and our true faith. Talk is cheap. Talk is cheap. But when you stand up for what you believe in, when you insist on the values that in which this country were founded upon, justice, liberty, and equality for all, when you insist on these values, which are in accordance and consistent with the values of Islam, when you stand up for what you believe in, when you teach your children that be proud as a Muslim, when you tell your wife, don't take off your hijab, this is the time to say that we live here equal. And you think, if you think that you can hide, if you think that you can withdraw inwards, and if you think you will just vanish from the map of this country, then I will advise you just take the first flight out of this country. It's not going to work. Bigotry needs to be confronted. Injustice needs to be defeated. America is no one's America, it's everyone's America. If you can't be that person, then I'm telling you, we're in a total loss. This is the time. Let's be proud of who we are. Let's be proud Muslims. Don't send the wrong message to your children. You will give up on one of your rights, they will give up on a principle. And don't blame them for it. You set a bad example, or we set a bad example. Brothers and sisters, let me conclude. We have so many issues. We have so many causes. But they all fit and fall under this purpose of our creation. Of worshiping Allah, of establishing this earth and inhabiting it, but by injecting a constructive force and justice. We have so many causes, including our causes here, including this cause, including the need to stand up and to rise up. But we have other causes. We have in Syria a cause, we have in Libya a cause, we have in Palestine a cause, we have in Myanmar a cause, we have in Central Africa, in Kashmir, in many places we have causes. Don't abandon your causes. Many would say, it is a different time. The tide has changed. No, it's not the tide that has changed. It will continue to change. But let's worry more about our religion, our faith changing or not. Because again, it is the time to prove ourselves. One of these causes is Palestine. I know, every time I come on this member, most of the time I ask for your support. But you know, I will tell you this. I consider this part of my mission. I consider this to be part of my fulfillment of the purpose of my creation. No one likes to come on a member and ask for anyone's help. The Prophet did do it, right? Did he ask for support from his community and his Sahaba? Did he ask for money? Did he? Yes, he did. Did he put him in his pocket? He died poor. There were loans that they had to pay after he died. But there was a reason why he asked for it. Because it is, again, a fulfillment of our creation and the purpose of our creation. We're going to continue to be engaged, Ikhwana. And the American Muslims for Palestine is one of the organizations that is engaged on behalf of everyone of us when it comes to this sacred issue of all of us. The issue of the Masjid al-Aqsa, the Aqsa Mosque, the issue of Al-Quds, Jerusalem, Baytul Maqdis, the issue of the Holy Land, Palestine, our first Qibla, the second mosque in terms of establishment, the third sanctuary in Islam, the land of Al-Isra and Al-Mi'raj, from where the Prophet ascended to the seven heavens, the compound, the mosque that gave us this, the framework of us being khayra ummatin ukhrijat linnas, the best ummah evolved for mankind, the normative ummah or the just ummah, the witnessing ummah, by believing and adhering to the true faith. We need to be engaged. Let me ask you this, is Palestine a just cause or not? Is it? Is it? If you abandon it and you can't do something, maybe the majority of us cannot put money, but whatever, maybe your dua, but if you can't put money, put money. I need a few minutes of your time after the prayer. We have a table outside. This organization is engaged in advocating for our rights, and remember, the Zionist movement is not only after Palestinians, it is part of the organization. It's one of the major players that are fueling Islamophobia and bigotry against us here in America. So don't say this is a Palestinian issue. We're here to be civically engaged. If you create a vacuum there, then trust me, you will create another vacuum somewhere else. Tomorrow, God forbid, they come after our masajid, create a vacuum. Don't create vacuums. Don't voluntarily give up your rights. Don't abandon justice. Don't abandon the purpose of your creation. Don't abandon your own conscience. I need a few minutes of your time to enable this work to continue on behalf of all of us, for not only the best of Palestine, the best of the Muslim Ummah, but also for the best of America. We chose this home. Make it better. Make it better. Allahumma ansur al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Wa adhill al-zalamata wal-zalimin. اللهم من أراد بهذا الدين خيرا فوفقه إلى كل خير ومن أراد به غير ذلك فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر اللهم ارحمنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك اللهم يا الله إنا نسألك أن تسهل القادم علينا وأن تمكر لنا وأن تجعل الخير فيما نخاف، وأن تجعل الخير فيما نحب، وأن تجعل الخير فيما ترضاه لنا يا أرحم الراحمين. وأنت يا أخي أقم الصلاة.